Nobody seems to be that much the worse for wear. Maybe you're involuntarily relaxing, involuntarily actually having time to yourself due to these artificial restrictions. But for most people today, and the younger you are, the more it's true, you don't know how to have the relaxation, have the quiet time, have this time to yourself that every human being has to have every single day. It's not once a week, it's not twice a week, it's every day. If you don't have some downtime, literal downtime. Downtime means you're doing nothing. And many people have accepted the programming, the conditioning of it's not okay to do nothing. I'm the poster boy for it's perfectly fine to do nothing. Doing nothing, I've honed it into an art form. But you haven't really picked it up from me. That's one of the things you should pick up from me. How to just be okay with doing nothing, and that feels good. Not because you're exhausted, not because you are stressed, not because you have run out of juice or the battery's empty, but because it's a part of life that has to be part of your everyday living, everyday way of apportioning the minutes of the day. There has to be downtime, real downtime, where you're not thinking about anything. I've said this many times, but it bears repeating, where you're not mulling anything over or rehearsing for tomorrow or reviewing what you did wrong today or drifting into daydreams about the distant past. Really, downtime means you're just relaxing. You're just totally chill, and it's as simple as that. You're not involved with anything mentally, physically, emotionally. You're just being. You're just there. You're not zoned out. You're not in a coma. You're not in a trance. You're not meditating. You're simply relaxing. And this is one of the most criminal acts of the last 50 years that the society, the crime of society, is they've taken this away from people. They've made you, especially in the Western world, they've made you wrongly see downtime as wasted time, because it's not generating a profit. Something's not getting done. Well, guess what? They've given you a very false message that life is for getting things done. Life is not for getting things done. And the hours of the day are not for getting things done. When Bob Dylan wrote a song quoting Bible verse, he was very accurate. Bob Dylan doesn't mess around. When he uses the Bible, he's using it right. So for everything, there's a time. You add the, all as a course, turn. And every day there needs to be a time for downtime. So some people are learning this for the first time because of coronavirus. One of the benefits, everything has its pluses and minuses, even the worst things. So that's one of the big pluses, is you may be learning in an enforced, not voluntary way, but still you're in the situation. So you can't help but learn what downtime really means, because you can't be sitting there in a homestay, restricted, not going out, or limited in your going out. You can't be sitting there and feeling restless or feeling like there's a lot to do and use that to avoid. In this situation, it's not easy to use that as a way to avoid actually doing downtime. Actually giving yourself a real break is all it is. Just giving yourself a break. There's not a day in your life you don't need a break. It isn't a luxury, it isn't a laziness, it's a required part of human life. It's built in. You can go if you're that type, but you need a break every day from the go. And if you're not the go type, you still need a break, whatever you're doing. whatever the pace, whatever the fullness of it, if it's a long list or a short list, none of that matters in relation to this. Every day, every single day, there has to be downtime. And that downtime isn't after you climb into bed and you lay there waiting to go to sleep. Downtime means you're up, you're alert, you're in life, you're not in some artificial situation. Really, going to bed is an artificial situation. It's totally different than the rest of the day. So it's part of your day, not part of your sleep night. It's not something you do for 5 minutes. Downtime means, if you want the real guideline, downtime means not less than an hour. Ideally more, but if it's less than an hour, you're not really achieving downtime. You're not really giving yourself what the human system requires. The human system requires stimulation and activity. And on the other hand, and going right along with it, the human system requires rest, relaxation, and non-preoccupation with anything. Stimulus, no stimulus. Stimulus, relaxation. The right balance between the two changes everything. Changes, evens out your mood, changes the extremities we tend to live, the pendulum we tend to live these days, which is going from one extreme to another extreme. It makes your health the way it should be. It promotes good health. It promotes mental health. It promotes emotional health. Because when you're not doing it, you are out of sync with the natural way. Everything, if you look around, all the animals, all the plants, if you could understand them better, even the rocks are living this lifestyle of alert and stimulated and alert and relaxed, chill, pendulum. So that's my hope, because I know some of you are caught in the, it's almost a requirement, so, but it's certainly not. It parades as a requirement, but the society requires you to think that you are to be productive at all times. Any minute that you're not engaged in some productive activity, you're wasting time. And that's about as toxic a teaching as I can think of. So if it's entered you, get rid of it. If it's affecting you, say no to it. If it's running your life, absolutely throw that out the window. And make sure it's a high window so it smashes. And live right. Live the way you're intended to live. You're intended to be active, and you're intended to rest. You're intended to get things done, and you're intended to enjoy just hanging out. Too much of either one is out of balance. And this is a universe that really, really likes balance. The society isn't interested in what the universe likes. It's interested in what it considers efficient or effective or profitable. It's a activity bias. The universe has a bias toward activity. And the human being has to not be out of balance, because the universe also has a bias toward balance. And when you're too out of balance, something happens metaphysically that forces you to be more in balance. Usually that's called illness. But there are other things that happen that kind of put you in a little better equilibrium. So if you're feeling stir crazy because of having to be restricted, then that tells you that you've taken on that conditioning too much, because it's not long enough to feel stir crazy yet. And if you're depressed by the whole thing, that tells you the same thing, that you're too accepting of the notion that all minutes of the day have to be productive, even if just in the sense of your own thought process. If you're depressed in this whole time of everything shutting down more and you being required to interact less and be less active, if that's a very depressing thing, then that means your system is totally geared to the achievement mentality. And it's actually emotionally difficult to bear not being able to do the movements of that, the activities of that. So if I had to guess, I wouldn't be able to, but for the sake of this conversation, I'm sure some of you are perfectly fine with this. And I'm addressing the ones who aren't. I'm addressing the ones who are finding it day by day more difficult. There's got to be some of you who are in that position. But I suspect the majority of you are chill enough that it's not a gigantic issue the way it probably is for a lot of super conventional people who have never recognized that society conditions you, that they would say, no, it's what I choose. But that's the perniciousness, the nastiness of the conditioning, is it convinces you that it's your own preference and your own choice and your own decision, when it's actually simply your response to what you perceive the society expects from you.